Good morning, children. In
Good
the
morning,
last
ma'am.
class, we had discussed about arteries, isn't it? One of the blood vessel. Yes, Sri Ram. What are called arteries, Sri Ram?
Krishna.
Yeah. What are called arteries? Yes. What are
arteries? Blood vessel.
Okay, blood vessel.
Mama, I will say.
Carries red blood cells.
Sorry?
It carries red blood cells.
It carries. I am asking about.
Ma'am, we haven't shared.
Yes. I am keeping it. I am taking it and making it ready for sharing. Understood?
Ammal will say.
Yeah. Yes, Lakshmi. Ammal, let me give a chance to Ammal. Let me see. What are arteries?
Arteries are the blood vessels which carry oxygen rich blood from the heart to all cell of the body.
Very good. Very good. Okay. See, Sri Ram, you forgot that OHC, that and all you forgot.
Odisha High Court.
Odisha High Court. That all you forgot.
No, ma'am.
No, then why you did not give the answer? Arteries away from oxygen, away from heart, isn't it? Carrying oxygen from heart to different parts of the cell. That all we learn, isn't it? Okay, so let me revise that one. See, arteries. Arteries are the blood vessels which carry oxygen rich blood, that is very important. Oxygen rich blood from the heart to all the parts of the body, or you can say all the cells of the body, isn't it?
Yes.
So the arteries lie quite deep under our skin and hence are not seen easily. Another point. The walls of the arteries are thick and elastic. Thick and elastic. The blood flows through them rapid and at high pressure. That is why the walls of the arteries are thick and elastic. Okay. So that all we learned in the last class. So shall we move to the next point?
Yeah.
What will be about it? What will be about it, children?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes. Yes.
Last day yes. You told us to find out about pyrivigens.
Yeah, ma'am. Post. FB post.
Once again, make it clear.
What ma'am, you told to find pyrivigens SB4.
Okay. See, after this, at the end of the class, we can discuss. Okay, I think you searched it, isn't it? Okay.
Yes.
Very good. Can you show the slide one more time?
Yes. See, children. So here, about veins. So shall we, after this, I will give time for discussing that. Okay. So veins. V4. W, just mark it, okay? Make it, remember that word, vein, V. V just forms into W. Okay, I will tell what it is mean. Veins are the blood vessels which carry carbon dioxide rich blood. Carbon dioxide rich blood from all the parts of the body back to the heart. Okay, carbon dioxide rich blood from all the parts of the body back to the heart. See, you know, during respiration, carbon dioxide is formed in each cells of our body. From their roll, these veins are taking this one. Veins are taking this carbon dioxide from each cells and they are bringing it back to the heart. Okay, they are bringing it back to the heart. So, veins. What are veins, Sriram? Sriram, what are veins?
Veins are the blood vessels which carry carbon dioxide rich blood from other parts of the body to the heart.
Okay. Emelina, What are veins?
Veins a blood cell which carry carbon dioxide rich is called from all the parts of the body back to heart is called vein.
Okay, so here you have to know, in the first point you have to note down some important points. Okay, veins are blood vessel. You should understand what are veins. They are blood vessel, one of the blood vessel. Okay, what is the difference between this blood vessel with from the other blood vessel? What is the difference of veins from the other?
Because this carry carbon dioxide.
Which carry carbon dioxide rich blood. Second
from
point.
All the parts back to the heart.
Okay, 1 minute. Which carry? So what? First question, what are veins? Veins are blood vessels. Okay, veins are blood vessel. Very important point. Another one. What is the difference of between this blood vessel from the other blood vessel? This blood vessel which carry carbon dioxide rich blood. Okay, this blood vessel is the one which carry carbon dioxide rich blood. Okay, carbon dioxide rich blood. So where it is transporting this one? From all the parts of the body back to the heart. From all the cells it is collecting and taking it back to the heart. These are called veins. These type of blood vessels are called veins. Okay, so now itself you can learn it. Okay, Hessa, tell me, what are veins? What are veins?
Ma'am, veins are blood vessels that carry.
Enough. Just I am making part by part questions. Okay. Veins are blood vessel. Got it? Yes, Amna. What is the difference between this blood vessel from the other blood vessels?
They carry.
Veins
carry blood rich in carbon dioxide.
Okay, blood rich in carbon dioxide. Yes, Anand. Yeah, this veins. Where it to transporting this carbon dioxide?
Veins transport from all parts of body back to the heart.
Okay, carbon dioxide from all parts of the body to back to the heart. So first point, is it definition of veins? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next one. Where we can see this vein? The veins are less deep. Okay. The veins are less deep and can be seen easily. So if you are looking at your hand itself, you can see this.
Yes, we can see. Yeah.
Bluish green blood vessel, very thin, isn't it? The veins are less deep and can be seen easily. Next point, since the blood flows at low pressure through it, the veins have thin walls. Another characteristic of vein, thin walls. Arteries, we learned, thick and elastic walls, but veins have thin walls. What is the reason behind it? What do these veins have thin walls?
Because it has only low pressure.
Yeah, this blood flows at low pressure through it. Through the veins, blood is flowing at low pressure. It is not coming from heart, isn't it? It is going to heart only. But arteries, blood. Mute your audio, children. So from arteries, blood is flowing from the heart. So that is why that blood after pumping, the blood is in high pressure. That is why it need to get a thick walled blood vessel for carrying blood from the heart. But here the blood is flowing as usual, in low pressure. So the veins have thin walls. Yes, Tanmay, why do the veins have thin walls? Why do now this?
Because, blood flows slowly in the vein.
Sorry, Tanmay, why?
In veins, the blood flows slowly.
At a low pressure. Okay, low pressure. We are not saying about slow or this one. See, pressure is pressure that it is controls the flow of blood. Okay, so low pressure, that is very important. Why do the veins have thin walls, Ayan? Ayan, why do the veins have thin walls? Yes, tell me fast. First, not hearing. Okay, Carolyn, why do the veins have thin walls?
The veins have thin walls because the blood flows at low pressure.
Through it. Okay, low pressure through it. Okay, Abhinav, Manoj, which blood vessel have thin walls? Abhinav, Bijoy. Abhinav, Bijoy, which blood vessel have thin walls?
Veins.
Okay. Next point. Veins have valves in them. Valves. So, what are valves? First, we want to know that. What are valves? See, just a thing. I am drawing the blood vessel. Okay. Vein here. Okay. Vein. See, children, just think about a door. Door which have two parts by which we can open it. Okay. In the same way, in the blood vessel, some doors are in between. Doors are there. Just imagine some doors are there all along the blood vessel. Say here I am keeping one door. Here it is another door. Can you see it when I am drawing, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so here we can see some doors. Okay, some old-fashioned doors are there. No, we can open it both part of it in the same way. So, like these doors are called valves. These valves are present in veins, only in veins. Okay, so veins have valves in them. What are called valves? So just imagine these are doors that restrict the flow of blood through it. Sorry?
Can open and close.
That is what I am going to say. Okay. Somebody told me it is going to open and close. So let me explain. So these are valves. Just like doors in our house. These doors have one particular character. They can open in one direction only. Only they can open in this direction. They can't open backside. They can't come back. They can only open. Understood? They can only open in one direction. They can't come back. Got it? Got the point?
Yes.
So why this arrangement? Why this arrangement there?
Ma'am.
Because the blood goes.
Because the blood may, as they are experiencing low pressure, the blood may flow back.
It is in order to prevent the blood to flow it back. Okay. These valves are present in the blood vessels in order to prevent the flow of blood to backward direction. So if the doors are opening only to one direction means the blood can only flow through it. Isn't it? When it comes back, it won't allow the blood to get into it. It can't move to the opposite direction. It can't open it in the opposite direction. So the valves may closed. If it comes in, the valves may closed. So they can't flow it backward direction. So these veins have valves, but arteries. But in the arteries, these valves are not present. Okay, and these valves are not present in them, which allow the blood in them to flow in one direction only, towards the heart. The valves prevent the backflow of blood in veins. So these all are about the veins. So when we are writing V, we should understand V makes W. What do you mean by this W?
Waste.
That is, veins carry carbon dioxide like waste. Okay, that means it is taking carbon dioxide from cells to heart. Okay, carbon dioxide from cells to heart. Got it? So this much is all about veins. Gokul Krishna. Yes, I am calling you. Yeah, what is the definition of veins, or what are veins?
Veins are the blood vessels which carries carbon dioxide, which from all part of the body back to heart.
Okay, you can make your own sentences. Okay, no problem. I am not insisting you to say the same sentences which I wrote it there. Okay, Parvati Menon. See, why do these veins have thin walls?
Because the blood flow in a low pressure.
Okay. So, Uma, where we can see these veins? Where you can see these veins? I can't hear you, Uma. Unmute.
I'm deep in skin.
Yeah, they are less deep and can be seen easily on the surface of our skin. Johan, what is there in the veins? Only in veins. What we can see only in veins? Valves. What is the function of valves in them?
Do not allow blood to flow back into the cells.
Okay, the valves prevent the backflow of blood in veins. That also you can tell. Okay, so about veins, is it clear everything?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Dilla. Yes. Which blood vessels carry carbon dioxide, Dilla? Which blood vessel carry carbon dioxide, Dilla? Blood vessel. Which blood vessel carry carbon dioxide? My question. Okay. Aditian. Yes. Which blood vessel? What is the name of the blood vessel which carry carbon dioxide?
Arteries.
Very good. Prajita.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, the answer is wrong, right?
1 minute.
That's
really
answered very good.
Prajita.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the name of the blood vessel that carry carbon dioxide?
Veins.
Aditin, today you are not attending the class. You are doing something there. Isn't it? That is why you failed to answer that question.
Yes.
What is the name of the blood vessel that carry carbon dioxide? What is that?
Veins.
V for W. Waste. That means carbon dioxide. Pranav.
Yes, ma'am.
Which blood vessel have valves in it?
Veins.
Sorry?
Veins.
Okay. Which blood, Ishal, which blood vessels have thin walls?
Ma'am, veins.
Okay. Nelvin. Through which blood vessel the blood flows in low pressure?
Veins.
Okay. So somewhat you understood about the veins. So can we move to the next topic? Is this the time is there?
Yes, ma'am. 15 more.
Okay. So next, can you tell me what is the other blood vessel? What is the name of that?
Capillaries.
So arteries, it is over. Veins, it is over. Next one, we want to learn about capillaries.
Okay. Ma'am, can you show that vein slide one more time?
Yes, sure. Okay. So at that time, let me ask you some questions also for to others. Okay. Okay.
Ma'am, after this, can you show the artery slide?
Arteries also, children, I will send it in the group. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Because if I am showing it now, it will be, otherwise at the end I will show it. Okay. You have to, you want to write it down, isn't it?
Yeah, ma'am, I'll take a screenshot.
1 minute. Okay. So arteries and veins. Yes, arteries. Arteries are the blood vessel. We see the, in the, these three points, only three points are there, but we have to make a lot of questions from it. Okay. OHC, the oxygen carrying from heart to different cells. Abhinand Krishna, which blood vessel carry oxygen from heart to different cells of our body?
Arteries.
Don't confuse it. Otherwise, you will find it difficult for while learning the working of our heart. Okay. So, in veins also, veins carry especially the waste. Okay. Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is produced in cells. So, from the cells to heart, it carries blood rich in carbon dioxide from cells to hearts. Don't forget it. So, shall I move to the next topic, capillaries?
Yes, ma'am.
Capillaries. What are capillaries? Capillaries are extremely thin blood vessels which connect arteries to veins. Very important point. Okay. Very important. So, in the smaller classes also, you might have learned about veins and arteries. But one more type of blood vessels are there. They are called capillaries. Okay. Capillaries are extremely very, very, see, veins you can
smallest
see.
Smallest vein in the body.
Yeah. Veins you can see it in your hand, isn't it? Now you just see your veins. So capillaries. Capillaries means even smaller than the veins. That is why it is told extremely thin blood vessels. So what is the name of the extremely thin blood vessels in our body?
Capillaries.
Okay. Lakshmi, what is the name of the extremely thin blood vessels that present in our body?
Capillaries.
Capillaries are extremely thin blood vessels which connects arteries to veins. Okay, so which blood vessels connect arteries to veins?
Capillaries.
Gauri Parvati, what is the name of the blood vessel that connects arteries and veins?
Capillaries.
So this is the capillary. You can see it here, capillaries, how thin it is. The veins and the arteries again branching out to form thin capillaries. Every cell of the body is near a capillary. Okay, these capillaries, most important thing. We told arteries will bring oxygen to cells. Veins will take carbon dioxide from the cell. That all we learned. But actually, these arteries and veins in the cell of each cell, these arteries and veins again turns into thinner blood vessel called capillaries.
Ma'am, veins will give carbon dioxide.
Take carbon dioxide. Isn't it? From cells.
From cells, yes. They take and give to heart.
Okay. That is. So, in cells, these veins and arteries again branched out to form capillaries. These capillaries are getting into each cell. Okay, it is not the veins, it is not the arteries. So, which is getting into each cell of our body?
Capillaries.
Capillaries. which blood vessel getting into each cell of our body?
Capillaries.
Important point. Okay. So these capillaries get into these capillaries. Every cell of the body is near a capillary. That means these capillaries are getting into each cell of our body. The exchange of substances between the blood and the body cells take place through capillaries. Another important point. So, in which blood vessel exchange of substances happens?
Capillaries.
Okay, the exchange of substances between the blood and the body cells take place through capillaries.
How it takes place?
That I will explain it later. Okay, so these are the important points about capillaries. Capillaries are extremely thin blood vessels which connect arteries to veins. Here you can see the artery. At the end of the artery, it is changed into capillary. And that capillary is at the other end. It is attached to vein. Isn't it? Capillaries, one end it is attached to artery and the other end it is attached to vein. Understood? So, yes. One end of the capillary is attached to arteries and the another end of the capillary is attached to veins. This arrangement helps the capillaries to exchange of substances between the blood and the body cells. Here all you can see the cells. So, let me go through these all points. After that, I will show the working. Malavika?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What are capillaries?
Capillaries are extremely thin blood vessels which connect arteries to veins.
Okay. Missyat, what is the name of the blood vessel which connect arteries to veins? Say it loud. Don't waste time. What is the name of the blood vessel which connects arteries to veins? Okay, Hessa, then tell me what is that answer?
Ma'am, capillaries.
Capillaries, okay. Every cell of the body is near a capillary, or you can say capillaries are opened up into each cell of our body. What is the function of Abhinand Krishna? What is the function of these capillaries, Abhinand? Yeah. What is the function? Third point indicates the function of capillaries. What is the function of capillaries? Abhinand?
The exchange of substance between the blood and the body cells takes place
through the capillaries. Okay. Milan, can you tell me the function of capillaries? What is the function of capillaries? Milan, fast.
Capillaries connect arteries to veins.
Function. What is its duty? What they are doing in our body? Milan.
Exchange of substances between both.
Very important. Okay, the exchange of substances between the blood and the body cells take place through capillaries. Okay, so I hope this is clear.
Ma'am, substances means what all?
Substances means what all? Who can say about substances?
Like heart, every part of the body.
Oxygen.
Yeah.
Then carbon dioxide.
Then
digested food.
Very good.
Then water.
So, oxygen, carbon dioxide, digested food, water, these all commonly we can call it as substances. Okay, substances. Exchange of substances take place in capillaries. Exchange of substances take place in capillaries. Got it? So, I will show you. I won't be able to complete the working of capillaries today. Anyhow, we can see. Children, can you see this picture here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
So through the artery, which type of blood is passing? Flowing.
Oxygen-rich blood.
Okay. O2-rich. Oxygen-rich blood is flowing to artery. See, these arteries are bringing oxygen, and this oxygen, these arteries are changing into capillaries. This each capillary is opens up into each cell. Can you so here small cells?
It is,
yeah, it is only diagrammatic representation. Okay, so each cell, arteries are oxygen carrying arteries are branched into capillaries. So each capillary get into the each cell carrying this oxygen. It will exchange that oxygen to the cell. And in the cell, what is present there? What it is produced due to respiration? Carbon dioxide is there in the cell. So these capillaries take this carbon dioxide, as they are very thin. They have very thin walls. They can exchange these gases. So oxygen is given to the cell, and from the cell carbon dioxide is taken. And the other end of the capillary, it is the veins. Okay, so capillaries, one end it is oxygen rich arteries, and the other end it is carbon dioxide rich veins.
Thanks.
So these capillaries exchange oxygen into the cell that flow through these arteries. The other end, it is connected to the veins. So this artery take carbon dioxide from the cell and gives it to veins. Veins. Okay. So the oxygenated blood from arteries enters into capillaries on all the parts of the body. The other end of the capillaries are joined to veins. Here you can see. At the same time, waste produced in the body cell enters into the blood through the thin walls of the capillary. From the picture itself, you can understand it. Isn't it, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. So likewise, capillaries help in the exchange of gases.
Ma'am, both the functions are done at one time, right? Same time.
Sorry, children?
Ma'am, both the functions are did at the same time,
At the same time. That how it make it possible means these capillaries have very, very, very thin walls. Okay. So that will help to exchange it through that walls. The oxygen is given to cells and carbon dioxide is taken from the cell. And arteries, one end of the capillaries is connected to arteries, another end it is connected to vein. So actually what we can say, exchange of substances between arteries and veins take place through the capillaries. At the beginning, when you learned about the blood vessels, you might have some confusion how they are exchanging these all things. Now is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, which blood vessel helps in the exchange of substances in our body?
Capillaries.
Okay. So, shall I take the attendance now?